ever. Yo. One person watching, it says. Ah, not too good. Get a headache. It's okay, nothing a little painkiller can't hurt or fix. Where does this go? Alright. Come on! Put it in. Doing this all by myself is a pain in the neck. Yeah, everybody's kind of out of it. The show must go on, yo. Can't do this. Where did I put my alcohol? Yo! You're back already. You know where my Viniq is? If he was to put it away, where would he put it? Huh? Hold on, people. I'm working on it. Huh?
Does the movie end at 9:30?
I have no idea. He didn't tell you?
I didn't go in.
Huh?
I didn't go in.
Oh, yeah. On the website. It's a tall bottle, right? Mm-hmm. Is Ian in the chat room? Maybe he would know. I'm just looking for my Viniq, since that's the first recipe. I don't know where Ian put it. Super fast. No, I don't have any Crusion. I don't think I have Crusion in that color or flavor. As far as I know, these are my banana.
Banana rum?
Yep. In Crusion form? Fantastic. Alright. Shaker. Camera. Probably focused around me. I'm gonna guess. Put these here. See what that does. This I'll put here. That here. Viniq. Banana rum. Citronge I don't have. Pineapple juice. Open this so I don't look stupid when I can't get it open. Ow! Boom!
Good.
That's on, this needs to be on. Click. End of the click. Slamming. do this, you. Let's do this. Oh. Whoa, what the heck? Oh. 26. It's 26. The magic number is 26. That is the magic number. Extra cock. Bitchin'. Oh, I gotta do my lead-ins without having Ian here. That's gonna be interesting. If they're worth doing, I guess. Alright. Ready? That. We're good. Welcome to Common Man Cocktails. I'm your host, Derrick Schommer, and I'm here by myself this week. I'm so nervous. I've got my live streamer, so there's 25 other people watching. And then whoever decides to watch this show is going to be watching it. Today we're going to be making a Viniq recipe. That's this crazy Schimmery liqueur. We've used it a couple times. If you search for Viniq Schimmery liqueur review on YouTube, you'll probably find us near the top, pretty close. And that's the stuff right there. It's got a little bit of a shimmer to it. That's why it's called Schimmery liqueur. Duh. And this recipe is submitted by Eric. Eric sent this. He's from Simply Made Cocktails. You can search him up on the YouTubes. And I think it's youtube.com/somethingmadecocktails. 2 ounces of Viniq. 1 ounce of banana rum. Eric called for Crujon. I don't seem to have Crujon for banana. I have Crujon for everything else, but not banana. So I'm going to use Malibu because I have Malibu banana that I don't even know if it's open. Oh, it is open. What do we use this for? Oh, we could use this instead of 99 bananas. Smells nice. All right. Spur of the moment.
Review, at least, I'm guessing.
Tastes like bananas. You could totally use this instead of banana liqueur. This is banana liqueur. But it's not as potent. It's only 21% instead of, what, 99? Or whatever, 99 proof. And that's, like, not 100 proof. So it's, I don't know. You figure out the math. And then he also called for Citronge from Patron. I don't have it. I'm going to use my next favorite. Well, my first favorite, Senior Curacao. This is a blue curacao, clear curacao, orange curacao. This one, as you can see, is clear. So you could use this. You could use whatever other orange liqueur you want. Try to stay away from bottom shelf triple sec if you can. But if you can't, whatever. Then we're going to add some pineapple juice. Done. And again, orange liqueur, triple sec, you know, like Cointreau for those of our French audience. However you can say that. And that's it. That's the whole recipe. You're going to shake it. You're going to strain it. You're going to throw it in a martini. I just started with these Nicanora glasses, so I figured I'd start using some of them, and it's cool. You can use a martini glass if you want to. Whatever. I will also find my little prongs. Oh, they were over here earlier. Where'd they go? They're following me. So we're going to prong that up. Let's measure this. We're going to do our 2 ounces. I'm going to do the Viniq last because I have this in my hand already. We're going to do, what was this, a half ounce? Boom. Half ounce. I don't remember the last time I actually made cocktails. Ian's always making the cocktails. So this is awkward. I don't know what to do. An ounce of Malibu. Boop, doop, doop. You think it's going to taste like Jennifer?
Awesome.
Super awesome in a glass. It's got a little bit of a grape or peach flavor, depending.
Grape, not peach.
Or both. Whatever.
Or grape.
2 ounces. Or the
I like
Moscato.
How it shimmers even when it's mixed. Or at least last time it did.
It shimmers as long as you don't let it sit for days. And I'll pour that in here. I don't know if it's still going to shimmer after this. And then a half ounce of pineapple juice. Just to make sure it's not too purple. Any thoughts on color? It's going to be weird. Shake that up. I need some place to pour my stuff. Chill the glass. Now it's cold. Now can we get it off? Yes, we can. Oh, the loveliness. Viniq Tropical Passion. I don't know where the passion comes from. Maybe because of the color. Done. Sorta.
because of the pineapple and coconut.
See, here's the issue. When you shake the Viniq, you're going to be giving it, you're going to lose the shimmer for a while, although it's still, no,
it's shimmering.
It's just cloudy shimmer. It looks like, kind of looks like the mica and stuff in the ocean water when it kind of kicks up and it gives that little, like near the end where the shoreline is, and you can see some of the flashiness from it. Or like a really cool purple paint job. But for you guys, you probably can't see it shimmer. It is shimmering. Trust me. It's kind of neat that it does that. It's kind of a pearl essence kind of look to it. And the beauty does smell like, kind of got a little grapey thing going on here. Yeah. I don't get any banana out of it. But the beauty of this glass over just a martini, if you're walking around with it, doesn't slosh around as much because it's, they're not flared out as much. Not that our martinis we normally carry are, they're pretty steep, but this is a little bit more fancy. And there's an, oh, it is, it gets more shimmery as you sit. Well, tell you one thing, a quarter ounce or a half ounce or whatever of pineapple juice does not tame the beast within this drink. It has got alcohol in the finish. Tastes like, kind of like grape a little bit, but it has a definite, like a banana citrus thing, which is really interesting because I'm picking out banana, but it's subtle. Most of the time, when you're using a banana liqueur, if you're using a very striking banana liqueur, it's like you're getting the runts action going on, like that banana runt. Then if you use a kind of a crappy one that doesn't have a lot of flavor, like, I don't even taste banana, why did I waste my money? This one, you get it, but you have to think about it. You take a sip, and this might be a drink that if you're sipping this with friends, and they're like, oh, what's that flavor? It's tropical flavor. Just go, call out banana. See if then they'll go, oh, yeah, there it is. But definitely has sweet banana, grape. I almost get peach schnapps in here, but I will get yelled at, even though I've had some people comment saying Viniq has a peach flavor to it. I get peach out of there. Pineapple juice, not so much. That's just the tropical, and it probably gives a nice little foaminess to it. It is getting really cool.
Question of the day.
And everything suspends. Yes, question of the day!
Favorite syrup to add to a dessert?
Dessert syrups! My aunt, her favorite syrup lately is the hibiscus, because she took some hibiscus flowers home and she's been putting on her ice cream. And now she, like, always puts hibiscus flowers on her ice cream, like one or two. I've heard a lot of, like, well, maybe not demerara syrup. That seems kind of weird to just throw molasses. Oh, or, like, yeah, like an almond syrup, like orgeat or falernum. What's your favorite syrup to add? I'm a stupid American. It's always just been chocolate syrup, strawberry syrup, and caramel syrup. Those are the three. There aren't any. Caramel is super wicked awesome. So if you like caramel.
Probably if it's like an ice cream stand where they get that. Hot and
gooey. Oh, you like hot caramel?
Caramel?
Yeah, and then the caramel that you put in the microwave to microwave it, yeah. It's cool, but it takes a while, and it's like, I just want to eat ice cream. I'm not making a process out of it, and then you've got to microwave it. Then you've got to seal it back up and then re-microwave it, but you've got to change the time in which you microwave it because the contents continue to reduce over time because you're eating it or whatever it is consuming. So there you go. Favorite dessert syrup. And do you use syrups that you also use for cocktails in your desserts? Because if you're smart, you do. Because if you have a bottle of syrups that's this big, unless you're making cocktails for parties and you're just putting a little in your cocktail, a half ounce here and there, this is going to last you forever. But if you put it on ice creams and I don't know what else.
Coffee.
This would be good. This basically, if you wanted to use a rich demerara syrup, you can use that instead of like sugar in the raw. And you, especially iced coffee. Because iced coffee, because it's so cold, it doesn't, whatever that is, it doesn't break down the sugar into a syrup very easily or into a liquid. It doesn't dissolve. So having a liquid would make more sense. That might be something I should use for my coffees. That's it. Question of the day, we did it. Cocktail is done. If you don't have Schimmery Liqueur, at the end of this video, I will put the review for the Viniq Schimmery Liqueur. So you could just click right on that and get to it. Because otherwise, I don't know what else I put at the end. That's it. We're done. Everyday drinkers, you can go to ostrich.com right now if you want to get these dainty little Nicanor glasses or martini glasses or any other glasses or your simple syrups. It's all there in one place, one-stop shop. Go there. Everydaydrinkers.com for everything else. We're teaching you how to drink. We did it. You know what? I'm not going to do lead-ins without this week because I don't think there's anything special going to happen. We'll just roll through it without the ads. Have an ad-free, promo-free week. Which is probably good because it'll probably be at the end of the month anyway.
Yep.
I have to retape a new one. Next one will be, what, Valentine's Day? What?
Yeah.
Do you want to see the beauty?
Do I want to taste it?
And see
I
it.
Can see it from over there.
You can see the glimmers?
Mm-hmm.
See, they won't be able to get that in live chat because it's a little blurry. My screen doesn't look too bad.
Glimmering now.
But it is a little bit blurry.
That's not bad. Eric made this?
I don't know. He submitted it. Yeah, it's funny when you go in and you buy this stuff and they're like, whoa! Like, you work here!
I know.
How do you not know this?
Because the cashiers don't stop.
Right. That's how you know you're the first one to buy it.
From that person.
That said,
whoa. Oh, yeah. Tuesday. Not shimmering anymore. I started shimmering over there, though.
It died? Oh, the lights over here are bright, too.
Yeah.
Speaking of syrups, let's bring one on. Pour into cut rocks glass and with ice stir.
You can do this later, man.
So a rocks glass. It's just the ginger. Yep. Do. Wait, this wasn't over here. Build over rocks. How are you gonna build a syrup-based drink into a rocks glass? Stir soda and water. That's kind of weird. What's a good dark Jamaican rum? I don't know if I have a dark Jamaican rum. I guess I have a dark Jamaican rum. This is gonna be potent, crazy. Schommer. Try and put your email address. Try it again.
Nope. Alright, well, it's recipe@everydaydrinkers.com.
recipe@everydaydrinkers.com. The easiest way to find it would be to watch any video and go to the recipe card at the end. It's all right down there. I don't know why you can't type Jarls. wonder if it sees this as you. Oh, there's one off to your page. My bad! Reynolds, dash aromatic bitters, top with soda water, lime wedge, put in a rocks glass with ice, stir. Mystery solved, Batman! Boom! Alright, ow. 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 That was not the button. Shit, that wasn't the button. It was the zoom button, but
it's already zoomed.
Ready, set, we're live in 5, 4. Really? Welcome to Common Man Cocktails. I'm your host, Derrick Schommer, and I've got with me nobody. I was supposed to get 2 guests this week. I ended up with no guests. Here's what happened. Ian got the flu. What are you going to do about that? And then Curtis's wife wouldn't let him come out and play or something. So Curtis was supposed to be here. I was hoping to be able to do like a nice reposado tasting and whatnot. None of that happened. All washed away. I'm drowning in my sorrows. Let's make a drink. This is called, I think it's the BlackBuck. If I spelled that right. This is really a Blair Reynolds recipe, Black Buck. Oh, it's on the back. So, this uses ginger liqueur. Some of these drinks this week, although I did do some modifications, were intended to be Curtis and Ian here, so I had planned. I know Curtis is always looking for a good ginger liqueur, Curtis, and I had one. I thought I'd give him a chance to sample it in a recipe. Sorry, liqueur would be bad. I would get arrested for selling those. Just a syrup. We just sold like 6 of these today. I don't know why. Maybe because I picked it up. So it's going to be 1.5 ounces of dark rum. Boom. We're going to do 3/4 of an ounce of B.G. Reynolds ginger syrup. You could use any ginger syrup you want, but B.G. Reynolds is good, so why would you pick a different one? Dash's aromatic bitters. For that, I'm going to use Bergen Hauk. If you have Angostura, like these, you could use that. If you have Peychaud, you could use that. If you have Scrap Ace, you could use that. Whatever. Everything says aromatic nowadays, but I like Bergen Hauk, so I'm using it. So there. And then we're going to have some soda water on top, lighten it up a little bit, because it's going to... Meiser's dark rum, it calls for a dark Jamaican rum. This is a dark rum from Jamaica. It seemed like the appropriate thing to do, because it was the only one I had. So. There is that. We have a question today yet? Build over ice. Yes, you're going to take a syrup, apparently, and you're going to build it over ice. So I'm going to start with the BG Reynolds itself. Now, I had a taste of this. 3/4 is a pretty good amount. I had a taste of this yesterday because I wanted to, and it doesn't have the hot spice that you get out of a ginger beer. Yeah, out of a ginger beer. But it... definitely tastes like you just put like a real fresh ginger in your mouth without that insane heat. It says fresh kick on it, but I couldn't get that. So I'm curious to know if I'm going to get it out of this drink, which would be kind of cool. Because there is a chance that adding... I was just drinking out of the bottle. There's a chance that adding some more liquids to it can break it up a little bit and get some more essences and flavors out of the drink. So what the heck, right? And then we're going to do a dash aromatic bitters. Now, when things typically call for a dash, they tend to actually mean more than just this. it's tough to tell. Every dash is a little different. So I usually do four, you know, around there to kind of get the dash. If you're doing dashes with a, that's not it, with like a bottle dripper, like the Seven Stills, to them a dash would be a half of the dropper. Probably about that much. Depends on how big your dropper is. But the standard dropper, a half is, basically it's not one drop. Oh, it doesn't solve world hunger with just a drop. Then we're going to add some club soda to kind of lighten it up a little bit. Yes, and the syrup is definitely at the bottom. Now you're going to need to stir it. Now if you use like a, well, you can't really use a ginger. I guess you could muddle ginger in here. That could be different. And then we're going to garnish it with the garnishy thing. In this case, it's going to be a lime wedge. Done! That, my friends, my heater's making so many noise over there. A little weird.
Pretty loud.
Yeah. Stop it! That's the black book right there. So here you go. You can see the particles floating around from the syrup. And some of the syrup is still kind of residually sitting on the bottom, so I'm going to guess it's either going to get spicier or sweeter as you drink. Well. Well, Meiser's does not disappoint on insane amount of rum in your face. It's not as sweet. This is driving me crazy. It's not as sweet as I thought it was going to be. Nah, it's getting there. Probably because some of the sweetness in the bottom. I would think this is a good shaken drink. It doesn't call to be shaken. You can shake it, shook it, however you want to call it, and then see if it makes a difference to you. I think it'll probably amp up the sweetness. The root, the ginger is definitely more of a darker, richer, organic-like flavor to it with mild spice. This is not a hot drink. This tastes more like ginger smells, if that makes sense. Because you don't smell heat, right? It doesn't burn you, but you smell ginger. So if you're looking for a syrup that's going to bring ginger without the immense amount of heat, definitely a good idea. Also, putting it in ginger beer, because I was thinking that would be redundant. However, ginger beer, a lot of that gets strained out or it's fermented out or whatnot if you let it go too long. This could bring a little bit more of that natural ginger flavor to it, but the ginger beer will probably itself be spicier, and I don't know why. That's not as spicy as I thought it would be. Personally, for me, I love spicy ginger, so I want it to be burn my face off, but everybody's a little bit different. In this case, not me. Questions?
No questions.
Come on! All right, question of the day. Here we go.
Do you like your ginger spicy?
Oh, that's kind of boring, but do you like your ginger spicy, or do you not like ginger at all? What season do you find ginger to be? I usually think spring and hot summer is when I like to drink my ginger drinks. This is a good drink. It's just not hot. Easily solvable, I guess. You can muddle some ginger in there to really amp it up. So, second question. When you build cocktails, you're thinking of cocktails to build, when you want to muddle something in there, what is your favorite fruit to add to it? Maybe it's even just a sangria. Watermelons, like, I like the idea of watermelon in my drink, but every time I make a watermelon drink, it's like, meh, it's not that impressive. I like watermelon. Huh?
It's mostly water.
It's just too watery, and it loses some of the sweetness of a watermelon when you start muddling it down. You put it into a wine, it's like alcoholic watermelon, but I don't know. If it comes down to me, I'd rather have vodka in my watermelon than champagne or wine, white wines.
What's your favorite foreign spirit? Cachaça, Mezcal,
Pisco,
Cognac, Grappa, etc.
Woo! That's a sale, my friends. It's got to be the ginger syrup. I would say, question of the day, yeah. Well, we'll ask that too. What's your favorite foreign product? And if you're in that country, it doesn't count. It has to be from someplace that you're not at. So I can say cachaça because I am not living in Brazil. If you're in Brazil, you can say vodka because you're not living in Russia. I don't know what we do in the U.S. We can't say bourbon, right? I think
Kentucky.
Yeah.
Whiskey.
I don't look at Kentucky is kind of like a foreign country to me. But for me, if I had to answer that, I would not say grappa. Grappa tastes like some bad in your mouth.
Your dad loves grappa.
My father loves grappa. You have to. It's a DNA thing. You have to have the gene for it. It didn't get passed on to me. For me, I'm gonna say probably. I'm gonna go with tequila. That's what I'm going to say.
Mezcal is horrible.
I'm not going to say mezcal. I'm going to go just with the family of tequila. That's it. You can go to awesomedrinks.com, get your wide old fashions.
Jonathan said, stick your finger in your ear now.
Oh, yeah. Oh! No, I'm not. No, no. No, I blocked myself. You get your ginger syrup and your wide old fashions with your ice molds at awesomedrinks.com if you love me. Otherwise, you can go do whatever you want. Buy from whoever it is. Like Prime, whatever. But you're not going to find any of that awesome stuff there, so why would you bother? No, that's the other stuff. Everyday drinkers for everything else. Or just go to youtube.com/everydaydrinkers. So you get all the stuff faster. Anyway. That's it. We're teaching you how to drink. Spicy enough for you.
Me? I don't like spicy. It's a little spicy.
You think that's spicy?
A little spicy. I get the spicy ginger.
I mean, I can see the ginger particles. But it's not that spicy. It's flavorful. I think this tastes better by itself. I can drink sugar all day. Like, yes! More sugar!
In? The top of the tower.
Yeah, the tower should hold.
I can't drink too much. I have to go get Liam.
There's that.
It's only 5 minutes down the road, but I still could fall asleep.
That would be what you're worried about. It's falling asleep.
The police station.
Thursday, Wednesday, what, Tuesday, Wednesday, oh, or Thursday. Oh, this one. This is going to be weird. You know what, let's use another shaker. Don't even have to go upstairs again. You know what we haven't done in a while? It's time to bring it out, Jennifer. Time to bring it. Oh, Jesus. Shake, strain, garnish. Oh, yeah, that. Boom. All right. Liqueur 43. Where are you? I'm trying to find one that's one of my six that aren't
open,
that are open. There's a lot of stuff at the bottom that just didn't get put back somehow. I'm trying to remember what it looks like. Okay. Should have a three on the top. Normally it goes into this section because, oh. Because it is. Yeah, but this
is gonna be awkward. Tastes anything like key lime? I'm all over it.
I think we'll get that. Oh, it's an ounce of lime juice. I don't think there's an ounce. I think we need another one.
Zoop.
go. All right. We're missing something. No. Lime juice, half and half. This?
Yeah.
26 or 28? It can be 30. Anyway, I think it's 28. I think it's 28 or 30. In this case, I think it's closer to 28. The top one's 18. I don't have those yet. This is Martini. Chill it up.
Lost the top. Oh, it's down there.
Yes. Somebody's trying to... Oh. So, is
oh,
the...
those are good candies. Cowtails.
What?
Cowtails. He said,
cowtails?
I know a recipe that Derrick can make. The drink itself tastes just like a cowtail candy, and it uses Liqueur 43.
What the hell is a cowtail?
That...
this is not...
the caramel with the, like, cream type stuff in the middle.
What? That's before my time.
No. Cowtail. I'm going to get pictures of a cowtail.
Yeah, you are. You could probably put cowtail and then preface that with candy. Wait, post that with... I don't know what the word is. I'm a little
right
more
here.
More.
Come here.
You can't just flip the laptop around.
Oh, I could.
it's light. You just...
Hold on. I'm going to make it big. There you go. Those are awesome. No, apparently I can't because I'm about to drop the stupid thing.
I don't know. I don't think I've ever seen that before.
You've never seen a cowtail?
Maybe.
It's caramel. It's kind of like those candies you like, those big, thick candies, only it's thin and in a small line. You know the ones
what
you
big,
always take
candies?
From Oma's house? The caramel with the cream in the center?
Oh, like the round ones with the pinwheel?
Yeah. That's
oh.
What cowtails are really long.
In much, like, your stomach's going to be like, ugh.
Yeah, long and thin, not...
So it's like a whatever those other ones are called, those caramel candies, but with just stretched. Fair enough. All right, we ready to figure out if this is gonna work or not. Here we go. Let's see what happens when you take creamer half and half and lime and put them together. There we go. Welcome to Calm Man Cocktails. I'm your host, Derrick Schommer, and today we're going to make the lime pie, key lime pie, martini, without key limes. These are just old, regular limes, nothing the keys. They're a little bit bigger. 1 1/4 ounce of Liqueur 43. Ah, that's always good. You get 1/2 ounce of vodka, 1 ounce of cream, and 1 ounce of lime. I'm curious. Oh, we're going to also, I beat the heck out of a, what do you call that stuff? Graham cracker to put on the rim of the glass. I am super curious on whether this is going to fly. Because when you take cream and you take lemon and you bring them together, weird things can happen. However, thanks to chemistry, sometimes when you shake things, they don't do that. So this is either going to come out perfectly fine. It's going to, excuse me, it's going to come out like yogurt. I've seen that happen. Or it's going to come out like bad. Which will it be? Or it could be awesome. So, in this specific case, I'm going to put the lime and the lemon in last. That way we have less time for them to start to do their thing. And we're just going to do 1 1/4 ounce. I said 1 1/2 ounce, I think. 1 1/4 ounce of Liqueur 43.
Liqueur 43 is awesome.
And you know it's awesome because it has a slow pour on the top to teach you, be careful, because you're going to want to drink this with your tongue.
with
it doesn't have a slow pour, and I thought it did. My other one did.
You lie.
And there's no slow pour, just porcelain. Dude, it should have like a little plastic.
You make up crap.
I don't know where my slow pour went. Maybe it never had one. Maybe I took it out so I could drink faster. Who knows? We'll bill it in the tin. And then a half ounce of vodka. Why vodka? Why not?
You need something to get the alcohol level up.
Yeah, because Liqueur 43 is only half as strong as you would hope it to be. I don't know. It's 31%. It's still pretty high. But it's not as high as adding 40% more. All right. Here's where the trick comes in. I'm still, you know what? I'm gonna add some ice in here first. I don't think I need seltzer for this drink. My God. I'm dying. All right. Lime. Measure this out. My lime is an utter disappointment. Horrible. Where did we get these?
Grocery store?
Dude, I never get a half ounce. Seriously. Good thing I had an extra over here. There we go. That lime wasn't crap. Oh, here goes my fan. Alright. Ounce of milk. We're gonna put this in our mouth and see what happens. I'll tell you right now. Ain't looking good. Whoa. Can't shake and move that at the same time. Alright, step two. Phase two. Operation two. Gonna take a little bit of lime because I can. Gonna get this out of the way. We'll wrap that lime right around the edge of this. Then we'll just stick it right into here. Da-da-da. Spin it around a little bit. Get ourselves a little cookie coating.
Graham cracker
cookie. And then see, based on what I'm looking at here, how this is going to come out. Nah, doesn't look like it's too gross. Now, key lime, one of the best parts is the crust. And the crust is made of graham cracker. So this does everything you would need it to do to make something flavorful and awesome. It's got a nice little rim to it. Let's give it a... It smells like graham cracker and lime.
I can smell the lime.
Whoa. Tastes like key lime to me. Gets it right here. Works. Now, if you're a 100% key lime lover, Jennifer, she may or may not like it as much as regular key lime, or this may be gone in a split second. Now, if you're thinking, I want to make this drink, but I don't feel like the 5 seconds it takes to make a cookie or make a graham cracker crusty like thing to it, it's not that hard. Put one graham cracker in a Ziploc bag and beat the hell out of it. Then, 5 seconds later, you got that. Graham crackers aren't really that hard to break. I just literally pounded the crap out of it, flipped it over, pounded some more, and boom, done. And it works perfectly fine. Use your lime. If you want to, you don't want to spare another lime. You got a little lime lefty over here. You just squeeze it around the edges. You got enough to stick it. You're good. It tastes like key lime pie. Key lime pie is like kind of a little bit sweet. But it's also got that tart bite with, what is the cream? It is whitish. It's probably whatever it's made out of. There's not that much key lime in key lime. What was the other ingredient in key lime pie? Milk?
No, it was
no.
Egg.
Eggs.
Yolk. Egg yolk.
Just the yolk?
Yeah.
The yellow yolk, the yolk.
The yolk, yolk.
Egg yolk and limes.
And juice. And
we got rid of the egg yolk. We use dairy. Eggs are not dairy. Because one's a cow. And one's a chicken. One's poultry.
What's that have to do with the price of tea in China?
Because it's not like key lime is made with eggs. And this is made with cows. There's a little bit of a difference. But it tastes good. It does the job. Perfect size glass for this, by the way. Because this has got that tartness where you, after dinner drink, you sit down. It's not going to knock you over. Half ounce of vodka, little liquor 43, which, by the way, out of every part of the ingredient, you don't really get a blat. It's not like, whoa, this is liquor 43 drink. This is a key lime pie. Liqueur 43 is just one of the components that gets you to the end.
Question of the day.
Question! Holy crap! We have a question of the day for you people!
All-time favorite pie.
All-time favorite pie. Poutine doesn't count. I would go with...
No, it's close.
I like the apple crisp, the whatever crisp stuff is. It's got to be bad for you. Probably brown sugar
butter
and butter.
Brown sugar, I think, is crisp.
Like, that's how you know it's awesome! When the ingredients don't contain anything that should keep you alive. What's yours?
I really like key lime pie.
She likes key lime
but
pie.
I do like apple pie, too.
I don't want to drink too much
of this. I like apple crisp.
Hmm.
I like Boston cream pie. There's so many pies.
Boston cream pie's not bad. I like apple pie with, like, the cinnamon center stuff. As long as I've got some vanilla ice cream. Apple crisp, I could just slide it into my mouth. Wouldn't even matter.
I think, and usually I'll go for a key lime if they have it, because I don't usually.
Yeah, if you don't have a lot of key
option,
lime pie,
yeah,
then it's definitely it's a change up.
Oh, turtle pie, that's a good one too.
Hmm?
Turtle pie.
Turtle pie. Who knew you could do that to turtles? Maybe you flip them upside down, get in their shell.
You're not nice.
You're the one who said turtle pie.
That's the name of it. Oh, is this like cowtail?
I don't know what the hell a cow tail is. There's a cow tail on a turtle pie, and it's the grossest thing I've ever seen.
Cow tails are awesome.
I've never even seen a tail on a cow. I guess they got those little tails.
With the
little...
They flap to fly away all the time.
Yeah, but they're not as useful as... Cows' tails, they must be pissed off with that design. They're like, so I could have had something that actually could get bugs away. Instead, like, I don't know, a fly swatter, and instead they have like this little puffy thing that they have to swing around and try and hit things. Or a big tail like a otter or
lemon
something
meringue,
that has tails that are big. Huh?
Lemon meringue, that's a good one too.
Eh. Whatever. Cheesecake. That's not a pie though. I guess it doesn't count. So, after you've answered the question about your favorite pie, by the way, probably one of the largest feedbacks we've had for questions of the day thus far has been the question about your best covered band. Or best cover of a song. We have tons of people who responded to that. Like, this should be pretty good. Dance for me with your damn pies. And then you go to AwesomeFreaks.com and you get the Nick and Nora glass.
Here, I'll show you a picture of Troy Pye.
And
make this awesome,
a Neon Boss shaker without the sticker, because that's mine. That doesn't do me any good. I don't know what that is. That's a turtle pie.
That's a turtle pie, yeah.
What's
the
top?
You've never been subject to a turtle pie either.
Subject to a turtle pie?
You've lived a horrible life, my friend.
Who gets subject to something like a pie?
That's
weird.
Awesome.
All right. So don't worry about limes and milk and curdling. When you put them into the shaker, I'm telling you right now, it doesn't look right, but it comes out with a nice meringue look to it. So that's fine, right? That's what you want. You don't want things that'll be curdled up and look all kinds of ugly. But I'm guessing over time that's going to start to look all kinds of ugly. So you better drink this thing within a good 30 minutes. This shouldn't be too hard. Everyday drinkers.
It's a small drink. You can't drink that within 30 minutes.
If you can't drink this drink within 30 minutes, you do not deserve to be watching this video. Is that good? Did I put the bar down? Did I lay it down?
Lay it down.
So go pick it up. We're teaching you how to drink! And who?
Who's stepping? Yeah, I know. We're gonna have to go get some cowtails so he can try them.
Cowtail video show. Cowtails. Woo! Do 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 cowtails. Woo!
No, that's not tails. I could. Yeah, I could.
Really? Yeah.
This is key lime.
Huh.
Ian missed this.
Oh, yeah, Ian likes key lime.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that dick. Should have been here.
Talk with soda water.
Okay. You actually cow-tipped, David.
That's a thing? I thought it was that was a fallacy. You can actually tip over a cow?
At night.
I thought that was just a joke.
This is pretty good.
This has a half ounce of fresh lime juice.
This drink will be done before 9 and you can go get William. And I can finish this drink.
Goes out and buys limes just in case I need them. I got an extra. I could have made a fruitation drink.
Couple pecans, pie shell, sweetened condensed milk. That's what's in key lime pie.
There is milk in there.
Brown sugar, butter, corn syrup, semi-sweet chocolate chips, tablespoon of more butter.
You need. You have to have 2 times as much
egg
butter.
Egg yolk and then sweetened white.
Sure sounds like it. I'm gonna use this one. Alright, gin. Fresh lime juice. Fresh orange juice. It's 2 ounces. I probably don't need that much. Simple syrup, club soda, orange slice garnish. I've got stuff like that. I'm sitting by the park bench, whatever those words are. Whoa, shiza. Alright. Oh, I forgot to time the last one, but what's this doing here? This. Need me any vodka? Guess that's a little overkill. Built in a highball glass. We have those. One, two, three, ooh, four, five, six, seven. 7 ounces.
That'd be a big drink.
Should do. Tom's Diner. You remember it? Tom's Diner?
Mm-hmm.
How did you remember that off the top of your head?
I don't know. I just remembered it.
Wow. Your amounts of radical detail are monumentally impressive on my face. Why the switch from Ustream to YouTube? Because I'm already here, I guess branding. Nobody, most of our viewers are from YouTube, so going over there for the sake of going over there just seemed kind of redundant. The interface is exactly the same on my side because I use the same program. And all my notifications, instead of just going out to my Ustream followers, will go out to everybody who watches the show. And if they feel like joining in, like the 60 people watching now, which is about what we had last week, then it works. There's no ads. The chat interface is a little bit better, except for the fact that you can't post URLs or really have any type of moderation to it. But
yeah,
that's like whatever.
But the scrolling and stuff. Like when scrolling works, updated, it's not. The scrolling got wonky.
Ustream blows for where's my knife? For interface. It's all like Java and bullshit. And Java traditionally sucks the wing.
No ads.
No ads is good. And something I totally didn't even know until last week, since I just was doing this for fun to figure out if it would work. The videos stay up live on, or stay up on YouTube like forever, and people watch them. And then there's ads and stuff after on the when you watch it, so I make like 20 cents. But it's 20 cents more than on Ustream. Email goes out with, to what?
David said there was no email to say that you've begun.
Yeah, I would assume so. I don't really know.
I thought people, that's why I knew people were watching, because they said they got a...
Yeah, you should get an update something. Like everything else. Like, however, you know what you do? If you want an email to say we went live, you could right-click on the subscribe button and then say send email notifications, which is the same as, who else is that? It's the way Ustream kind of works, but it also works for when a new video comes out, it'll email you.
On Facebook.
Oh, I have no idea. I just post something on Facebook. Oh, if you didn't get the post I put on Facebook that said I'm starting... That's because Facebook only sends out to 3% of the audience, and it picks who gets it. So,
really?
Yeah. If I post something in my on my channel, only 3% of everybody gets it. Unless I pay them money, then it'll go up to 5%. But you'll never get more than that. That way you don't have all these businesses spamming people and going everything. They changed it like a year and a half ago so that not everything gets pushed. It's annoying for brands, but I guess for people it's better. Whatever. All right. Ready to do this? I guess I should restart this. Reset. Boom. Welcome to Common Man Cocktails. I'm your host, Derrick Schommer. Today we're going to be making the Stone Ricky. This is like the Lime Ricky or any other Ricky, which there's history behind Ricky. I didn't put it in this episode because I was in a rush. And I changed this recipe at the last moment to be a different recipe to this one. The other recipe you'll see probably next week. 1.5 ounces of gin in a Stone Ricky, so it's a gin-based cocktail. We're using Wireworks. These are the guys from Grand 10. It's a Boston-based gin company. We've got fresh lime juice, which is actually hiding in the back here. We've got fresh orange juice, which I will thus squeeze with my hands.
Hopefully cutting it first.
I have carpal tunnel, so this is not easy to squeeze. 1 ounce of simple syrup, and it's so awesome it's growing rocks in the bottom. 3 ounces of club soda. I'm gonna use Perrier. Perrier lime. You could use regular club soda, like, you know, like a seltzer water club soda. Bubbly carbonated water, not tonic. It's the only big difference. And which has quinine and whatnot in it, and a little bit of sugar. No quinine, no sugar. Orange slice garnish. Yada, you could do that. I'll see if I remember to make an orange slice garnish. I need 2 ounces. So, I don't know. Is this 2 ounces? We'll figure it out. I need something to measure it with. And since I'm on a roll of not cleaning anything yet today, I'll just use yet another measuring thing. Do-do-do-do. I don't know. I'll have to look at it. It might just need to be cleaned. These look like blood oranges.
Yeah, they do.
They don't smell like them, but whatever. So, I'll use an orange. This is going to be built in a highball, also, by the way, so you don't have to put any shaker work into this. Oh, sweet. The chefin makes so much freaking juice that it's like mega awesome. It's like Megatron minus the purple gun. All right. Won't need all of this. I almost want to just...
leaking it everywhere.
Well, what are you going to do? I just want to put it over my head and just drill it into my mouth, but it would just go everywhere.
It would.
It'd be like a...
people would laugh at you.
Porn or something. All right.
Really?
What do I need? I need ice. Boom. Boom. Boom! This glass? This one?
That one is monster.
It's a cobalt rimmed highball. I started carrying these.
It's a thick highball.
Yeah. I started carrying them because I accidentally ordered them. They were supposed to be the zombies that we sell, and they're not. They're highballs. It was off by a skew, by one, and I ended up getting those instead. I was going to yell at them, and then I realized I actually did it by accident.
You can still yell.
I'm not that type of guy, but those types of guys do exist that would be like, you did this wrong. And you're like, no, I didn't. But no, I took ownership of the problem and I decided to turn lemons into limes and sell them.
Okay, that's okay.
Hold on,
I'm smiling at you.
Oh no. Yes. Okay, that was awesome. An ounce. This is rich, simple syrup, so it's super thick, and it just, like, clings.
You should put it in first.
3 ounces. Put it in first? What's the fun in that? Need more ice. All right. 3 ounces. Two, three, done. Look at that, this glass, not as big as one might think. Done, now you can garnish it. I'm not gonna bother because I've already pretty much beaten the crap out of my oranges that are red. I don't have any stickers on, but that's not a blood orange. I didn't buy blood oranges. I don't know why they're red like that. All right. Smells like a gin-based cocktail, so if you like gin Rickeys, I bet you that's a thing, then this might be for you. Stone Ricky. I'm guessing because it's like a stone sour, like it has a sour component. Oh, it's actually almost balanced towards sweet. But the gin is a little distraction from the sour. It doesn't have, probably because of the club soda, it doesn't have as much of this. What do you call it? Like citrus, like the acidic. Like it doesn't have a lot of that acidic that makes you want to keep drinking over and over. It's more of a refreshing drink. So if you lived in, I don't know, Australia, where it's hot, this would probably be a good poolside drink. Let me see. 1.5 ounces of gin. That's your only alcoholic ingredient, fresh orange juice. There's nothing wrong with this drink. This is probably almost healthy.
Question of the day?
Almost question of the day. Yes!
Oddest cocktail / shooter you ever had? And do you like roller coasters? If so, what's your favorite?
Whoa. Okay, oddest and cocktail shooter?
Cocktail like tapeworm? Shooter.
Or smoker's cough? Right. And then roller coasters?
If you like them.
What's your favorite roller coaster?
And what's your favorite Pokemon?
What's your favorite Pokemon? Guys, how old are you? Your camera's over here. Just because I'm reading your text doesn't mean you can see me over there. How old are you? Pokemon? It's Magic the Gathering, dude. What favorite roller coaster? I'll answer that question and say I don't know. The, you know what? The Aerosmith roller coaster at Disney was cool.
It's cool.
because that was the first roller coaster I went on where I almost wanted to soil myself when I saw it. And then after
the
I had been on Dueling Dragons.
It's not there anymore.
What is it now?
That was Harry Potter World, but it used to be at Universal Studios, the Dueling Dragons.
That's Harry Potter World, the one we went to with that 3D ride?
Yeah.
That was where the Dueling Dragons were?
Yeah.
They took it away?
No, I think they made it into some Harry Potter type.
So they just redesigned it.
Yeah, I think. But I don't know if it's still two at the same time. Well, because we had kids and they weren't tall enough to go on.
That's right.
So.
You're right. Yeah. It's probably the same thing with different colors to it.
Maybe.
I like the Dueling Dragons. That was a good one.
Yeah.
The Hulk
was pretty good too.
At Universal Studios. That was always fun. I'm not the type of guy that wants to go on like the scariest and biggest roller coaster. I get scared at any roller coaster. I don't care what it is. So for me, anything is impressive when you're looking at roller coasters. The last question, something to do with drinking pig water? I don't remember.
Huh? What's your favorite Pokemon?
Oh yeah, Pokemon, pig water. I don't know what pig water is. Pig water is water left over after pig moves on. Is it pee? Is it just mud? Who knows? That, my friends, is a drink. By the way, this drink, let me see how many I didn't credit this week. BlackBuck, Viniq, I did that. So, the key lime pie, last recipe was submitted by James. It's in the live stream comments. I put it in there. It's right down below. And then you can go there and find it, James. The Stone Ricky, this is a recipe I got from the book Dale DeGroff. So, just to give you, to brush up, because I've had, for some reason, the last 2 weeks, a lot of people saying, where do I start? Two things on that. So first, this book, The Craft of the Cocktail, I found to be really good. Not Dale's first book, but, and I don't carry books, so you can buy these on Amazon. I'd send you my affiliate link at the bottom. I probably will forget. But Dale DeGroff put out a good book. This book has really good classic recipes in it that are easy to make somewhat. Some of them require some ingredients that you might not have. They give you a little bit of history and ones that have some history to them. And the first part of the book covers everything about alcohol. What's vodka? What's rum? Why do you do this? Why do you do that? How do you make drinks? It's all kind of comprehensive in here. So that's why it's kind of a good pickup book for a newbie. If you want to go to the next level, Liquid Intelligence from Dave Arnold. Another really fantastic book, but I think you kind of need something like this first. If you're totally intimidated, that book will just make your mind explode. And then if you want to know things about like the roots of vodkas and rums, you're just going to have to wait on that because me and Ian are working on a special project for you guys that we hope to be able to record and implement that will answer most of the questions about how do you start stocking your bar and what are the root drinks you should worry about being able to make. So stay tuned for that sometime. That, my friends, is it. Thanks for all the people who showed up for the live stream. We got one more video to go. Questions of the day is done. EverydayDrinks.com. If you want to go there, you can go to Facebook.com/CocktailTV if you want to catch up us on Facebook and make my numbers bigger than some other people who started after me that are already beating me, like Peter. And that's it. We're done. We're dishing out a drink. Oh, I look like a Skylander when I do that? Mm-hmm. What if I go like this?
Fly, maybe.
A fly?
Oh, no, that's not bad. I'm not even a big, huge gin fan. But
you could taste the gin.
You can, but it's not bad.
Oh, shh.
What was the book before Liquid Intelligence? The Dale DeGroff?
Dale DeGroff. It is The Craft of the Cocktail. The Craft.
I'm holding it up right now. That's actually really good. I could drink that. And I don't drink gin.
You just did. You could drink it more and more.
I could drink the whole thing if I didn't have to go get Liam.
I thought you were making me do that.
Oh, I am if you're...
I only have one recipe left. 7:46.
What is this? Why are you giving this to me?
Let's see if we can take it. Just lime water.
Alright, that's the case. I'll drink it then. Fruit fly, yes.
Fruit fly?
You held the orange.
Oh, I was a fruit fly. Okay.
I don't know about fruit fly, but fly.
Almost done my rock candies here.
Can I pull this off without having to wash anything?
Let's just see. What am I making? Oh. Yeah.
All right. Let's see if we can do this.
I like this.
I like it. Make it.
You have it. It's yours.
I wonder if I like it because it's red. I think it's better with the fresh orange juice.
Probably. The next drink doesn't have fresh orange juice.
But it does have orange juice.
And it's a shooter, so it'll go down nice and easy.
This could be my go-to drink now.
It's not going to get you too
drunk. My daiquiri is going to be my go-to drink. I'm going to make you bring everywhere.
Wow.
It's going to make you bring everywhere now. When you say, what could we bring, daiquiri?
Look, I'm Madonna.
Great. Living in a material world?
Yep.
So I am a material girl?
Yep.
Deep fried hot dogs, that is nasty.
Somebody's like, I got a joke. What if we take something that will kill you and make it kill you more?
And deep fried in oil.
Double deep fried.
What?
What?
Jaeger, grenadine, and orange juice?
First off, Jaeger and orange juice is not a far-fetched product combination.
Second off, that's all I got.
Alright. I'm going to add, let's see, how do I do this? I'm going to add orange juice, and then I'm going to top it with Jaeger. And I put blue curacao and grenadine down the sides.
The only other schnapps makers besides the Cooper, the Kuiper, however you want to say it. I said balls.
Arrow?
Yeah.
Alright.
How about you guys have an episode where you're given random ingredients and you have to make a drink?
That doesn't sound like an episode. That sounds like chaos. That would be what you do for, like, if you were to do, like, one of those marathon, stay up or stay awake for some holiday or whatever and just have a cocktail
like
marathon.
New Year's Eve, yeah. Yeah. Want to do that one year?
Yeah, make me a drink.
Kurt's not allowed to hang out with us anymore, though, so.
So he can't have that?
Yeah.
Yes, use a spin wheel. That would really make for great drinks. Oh, I need to actually start adding stuff, huh?
You just came around and said you're Madonna.
Really?
Yeah.
Where am I over here? I'm not there. Over here, I'm like, are you caught up on the live part? Can you forward? Like, does it say you're live, or is there...
This is live.
Huh, if you reload, maybe it'll be different, because I'm now just getting up to go turn that camera on.
No, you're sitting down. You just did the Jaeger and the blue curacao. You sat down. Now you're getting up.
It's catching up, because I just sat back down again. Now I'm looking at the camera, talking to you about what you just did. Weird. Anyway. They'll get there eventually. Ready?
Ready.
Oops, I shut down my clock. Welcome to Sunday Night Shooters! I'm your host, Derrick Schommer, and I think that's it for me this week. After this drink, maybe Ian will be back if he decides he doesn't want to get the flu or get sick or...
Or he actually recovers from the
throw
flu.
Up. Yeah. If it doesn't, if it takes you more than a week to recover, you've got a problem.
David said it took him a week and a half.
David's pussy. It's a different sickness. He's down with the sickness. This is called the Meiser on Mars, submitted by Stefan. I went out and I looked. Maybe it's Steven. I might have been German there for a second. Sorry. My bad. And I went out and looked. And the only one I could see that, because I want to know, is this a real recipe? Like, this is the recipe here. We've got, you know, craziness. And the only other person I've seen it on a couple websites. And then I saw Tipsy Bartender did it like 2 years ago. So it's not new. It was submitted a while ago, too. But there you go. Your ingredients are going to be orange juice, Jaeger, blue curacao, grenadine, and you're going to put it in a shot glass, and you're going to wait a minute and see if it freaking works itself out. It's going to be a fight. So what you're going to do first is you're going to take 3/4 of orange juice, and you're going to pour it into each one of your glasses. And because there's not a lot after this is your main ingredient, you're going to do 3/4 orange juice and then 1/4 ounce of the rest of the ingredients. At this point, it's literally just a show thing. I mean, 1/4 ounce of Jägermeister, that's not going to hurt you. It's not going to hurt anybody. But you're
going to like Jägermeister,
mate. You have to really hate Jägermeister not to be able to put 1/4 ounce of it in your body. I'm thinking you'll be fine. And then, so you're supposed to sort of top this, which naturally is going to work because orange juice is sweeter, more sugar than Jäger, which doesn't have sugar that I know of. It's a secret ingredient. You have to kill somebody to find out for sure. But we're going to assume it doesn't. Or it has a little bit of it, not much. So you could use a layering tool for this, but...
But you're so elite, you don't even need it.
I don't need it. I'm like, I'm awesome. That's it. I'm dying for some reason. It's my Uber micro. So, now you have your two top ingredients. Now, you're...
David said he's not a wuss, he's just old. Lol.
It's catching up, I think. Blue curacao, and then we're going to add grenadine. These are going to go down the sides, and then we just wait to see what they do. So, 1/4 ounce. This is where I kind of get lazy. I'm going to use my... I used to sell these, but I don't know.
You're not lead anymore.
I'm not sure if I'm going to sell anymore. What do I do?
You
need
the tool.
Oh. Fine. I'll show you what one looks like with the tool and without. If they look the same.
Sinking below the... Weird.
This is where craziness happens.
Oh, and it's turning green because it's mixing with the OJ.
Yep.
Mixing.
See how it comes out doing it by hand. Looks the same to me. Then, the grenadine. This, my friend, shall sink.
No, yours is not as fine line.
You're saying mine sounds good?
Pretty much.
Well then. Just to prove you wrong, I will commence layering by hand with this one.
You can drink the ugly one, and I'll have the pretty one. Really? You're making it all go down. Oh, you made it look horrible.
Why?
Turn it.
Well, yeah, but that's going to happen. The other one's doing the same thing. You just can't see it because I put...
Not as bad as yours.
Listen, it's like the same.
Yeah.
Ooh, that's a roller coaster flavor right there in your mouth. So, now you bide your time, and it just kind of looks weird.
Yes, it does.
I'll move them over here so you can see. And depending on how much you splash it, how perfect your...
I see your bottom has funky colors.
Which one's mine? I can't even tell.
Yeah, right. You dragged some other crap down to the bottom with your grenadine.
This one? No.
No.
This one?
Yeah, turn it. Yeah, see, you can see
it. Oh, that's just... It just took some blue curacao with it.
Yeah.
That's part of what Mars looks like there. Well, Mars has like the... I guess that's... I don't know. Kind of looks weird. But it's a green... It's a brown, green... whatever. So... You want me to drink one? You drink one after, or since you can't get up for it.
Whatever.
I'll drink mine.
Okay. I told you I wanted the pretty one.
All right. Here we go. It's a little sweet. It's like sweet cough medicine. That would probably be the Jaeger herbalness playing off the orange. Then you have pomegranate, and it ends with a sour. I don't know why. Maybe that's just what happens when Jägermeister mixes with orange juice. Good job over there spilling all over your face with your Stone Ricky. This drink might look cooler or less cool with pulpless orange juice. If you use like just a completely pulpless orange juice, because it kind of leaves some particles growing inside of the inside of the blue curacao. I would say don't use a good blue curacao. If you have like a lower end blue curacao, like I don't know, $5 to $15, or you have a $25 blue curacao or higher, I wouldn't go out of your way to make this with this because you think that the flavor, the essence of the drink is going to be better. Probably tastes the same. Tastes a little bit like sweet orange juice meets herbal liqueur. Jaeger.
Question of the day.
Do you have a question for me?
I have three questions for you.
That is what happens, my friend, when you start streaming on YouTube. You get people sending QOTDs.
Worst drinking story.
I need your worst drinking story.
Favorite TV show.
Favorite TV show.
If money were no object, what would you do all day?
If you had all the money in the world, what would you do? I would build a business. It's fun. What if you fail? Who cares? What if you want to carry everything in the world on tonics? Wouldn't matter. Ship it.
I would definitely do something, because I've been sitting around a lot, so yeah. I can't really do.
How's your sitting going?
I am just bored out of my mind. So even if I had all the money in the world, I would have to do something.
That's what I'm saying. You could do your own business. It wouldn't matter if you succeed or fail. I'd probably buy a newspaper company, and then I'd put them out of business and make my own magazine.
And then go out of business anyway, because magazines don't sell.
No, just like a niche magazine. If we had a cocktail magazine, come on, guys. If we had a cocktail magazine every month, came out with a whole bunch of cocktails, some history, some stuff around it. I don't see any of that stuff. If they had a magazine like that, maybe Imbibe. Then that's a thing. There's a thing there. That's what you do when you have lots of time and money. Then you have your worst drinking story, and then the other one I wanted to save because I thought it would be an interesting thing to bring up here. What was the question
favorite
today?
Favorite TV show.
Oh yeah, favorite TV show. Because that's harder for me to think about. I would say my favorite TV show is anything that starts with the word Star Trek. I also liked Battlestar Galactica when that was on, which I still want to get Jennifer to watch.
Big Bang Theory.
Big Bang Theory. Yeah, see, it all depends. It's trendy, right? Right now, Big Bang Theory's all in. I'd be like, Big Bang Theory, Two and a Half Men's fun.
Chicago Fire.
Dramas, they can give or take. They all seem to kind of all be the same.
Dramas.
Yeah, they're just...
I know, I watch them all without you.
I know. That's why I don't bother getting into them. Dramas, you have
but
to
know. We are watching True Blood, which True I know Blood. Isn't trendy because it's old now, but...
Yeah, it's a TV. It's not really TV. It's kind of premium TV. I don't know where that fits.
HBO.
So there. Answer that. What's your favorite TV show? Hey, what's your best YouTube show? It might not be me. Could be somebody else. Let us know. That's it. We're done. Here's your, why did I just get an error? Anybody else get an error on the live stream, or just me?
Just you.
Oh, sweet. Oh, look, a pre-roll. There's ads in my stream, and I'm the one streaming it!
That looks like something Ian probably tossed last night. Because he had the flu.
Yeah, so there is your drink for the Ian tossage. And this, my friends, is Jack Rudy. You can go out and get yourself a small batch of grenadine if you're looking for a natural and awesome grenadine.
Like Penny with her haircut?
No. No. Guess that's it, folks. We're done. EverydayDrinkers.com, CMC Shot Glasses. You can get those at AwesomeDrinks.com as well. We're done! We'll teach you how to drink.
Magnum P.I.
Magnum P.I.? How come I can't get to the live stream?
I don't know. You're not cool.
It says it's not even live. Maybe I just have to catch up.
It's live.
So you're watching it.
I don't know. I'm watching something. As you would.
Yeah, now it says it's live. Huh. That's weird. Oh, you want this?
Sure. Futurama.
Boom.
Oh, yeah, Walking Dead is good.
Walking Dead, yep.
Oh. You get Jaeger.
Herbal.
I get a lot of Jaeger.
Really? A little bit of herbal.
Yeah, you should have no pulp. It's got particles.
They just kind of floating around there. They're not like, it's not curdling. I don't have a non-pulp version of orange juice, so I'm just like, this is it. If you would have made, I guess I could have tea-strained it over. I thought that said,
alien. I drank that. That was really good. I like it.
I like how you're proud of it. I did. I drank it. Why is my little tablet keep going, bah-dah! Why is it doing that, Jennifer?
Yes, we're filmed before a live studio audience.
Yeah.
A live internet audience.
Oh, somebody killed me. Oh, I hate when that happens. Oh, and they raided me for 124,000 gold. Suck.
What? I can't drink Perrier.
Perrier?
I can drink Perrier. Lime.
You don't like Perrier? Mm-hmm. But you're okay with that?
I could do the lime or the lemon or the grapefruit. I don't even like grapefruit.
Pamplemousse?
Pamplemousse. iCarly, seriously?
Drake and Josh. Like the Drake when he gets older and he's thinner? Or like the fat Drake?
No, that's Josh.
Oh, whatever.
Drake is never fat.
Yeah, he's always skinny. But he's got moppy hair.
Okay.
Well, guess what he's got. iCarly because... Baby Spencer!
Spencer's hilarious.
Mm-hmm. If I could have anybody on Common Man Cocktails, I want it to be... His name's not really Spencer, but...
No, it's a...
Rainer. Rainer. Something... No, Jerry Trainer.
Yeah.
Jerry Trainer?
I think it's a trainer. Something.
Jerry Trainer?
Oh,
Google it.
Jerry. What is Spencer...
When will I try Sobieski vodka? Does it have to be a specific type of Sobieski vodka? Do I have any?
Yeah, Jerry Trainer.
Is it?
Yep.
I'm the man!
And Noah Monk as Gibby.
Gibby! Did you just call him Noah?
Noah.
I heard you say Noah Monk. No.
Yeah. As Gibby.
It says that. I had Sobieski. I don't have regular Sobieski.
Do you like the office? Yeah, I like the office.
Yeah, it's
not
over
anymore.
Who do I claim winner of the Super Bowl? I don't like to claim.
Obviously, the Patriots.
I hope the Patriots. But I have seen the Patriots go and lose the Super Bowl. So I try never to make those type of obvious choices.
You gotta be a fan. You obviously gotta say your team's gonna win. Whether they win or not, you still gotta say they're gonna win.
They'll win.
I said they weren't even going to win the playoffs, so.
Well.
I didn't know if they were going to make it by Baltimore. I had a good feeling about Indy.
What the heck is Jacksepticeye? I don't know what channel that is. Sobieski, if it's relatively cheap, it's probably fine. I only have espresso. And I don't even know where it is. But there is espresso vodka around here. Somewhere. I don't. All my vodka is right there. So, I don't know where else it would be. Good question.
I don't know.
Yeah, I'll have to shoot Jerry Trainer an at response on Twitter and be like, you need to be on Common Man Cocktails. It would be great for your career. And
you're just so cool that
right.
You need to be on here.
And I want to do a Baby Spencer skit. We can call him Baby Jerry, just to make sure it's not like the original. We could put him right here, and we could feed him shots.
The Gronk.
There's no room. He'd be like here.
He'd be like Curtis.
No. Curtis cannot be the same size as Gronk. Gronk has got to be bigger than Curtis.
I don't know how tall is Gronk. How tall is Gronk?
Google.
6'6".
Gronk is 6'6".
Well, Tom Brady's 6'4".
Now Google, how tall is Curtis McMillan?
I think he's 6'2 or something. 6'3 maybe.
No, my cousin was not replaced.
Gronk is taller, yes.
No, Doug moved back to North Carolina 2 years ago, and it becomes impossible to record with him.
Tom Brady's pretty tall. He's 6'4".
Brady's 6'4"? That's nothing. Gronk is 6'6".
That's tall. That's a big old boy.
I'm telling you, you put a 6'6 guy right here.
And you're going to look even smaller.
I'm going to be like this little dude. You'd have to, even if I had the whole bar set up, it would
even
be worse.
Ian may look small to Gronk.
It would just have to be Ian hosting then.
Doug wasn't on one day ago.
Doug was not here a day ago. I guarantee you that. That just didn't happen. It depends on what you mean by motivation. Now or before? Oh, it's a gaming channel. I don't watch any gaming channels. It's just
yes?
No.
Can I help you?
No, if you want to see Doug, you have to go look at, just look at the highlight video on the front of our homepage. What?
I'm here.
Yes, she wants to stay and watch Guardians of the Galaxy.
Well, I didn't hear you come in.
It's because I came right here. I was coming through here, and then I said, plop.
She is set, plop.
I'm not going to walk all the way up there to walk all the way down here to go plop.
Right.
Plop!
Plop!
Plop. Did you get that from Gracie?
What is good sure. Mythical yeah. Morning? Yes, that's Ian. I'm just live streaming. We're done. Recording.
Something to drink?
That's, you're not going to like that. There you go. Jennifer's got some water. Mom has water. You could drink some of the ginger syrup. She's probably expecting something sweet.
You want pamplemousse instead?
We don't have pamplemousse.
I know. I just want to say pamplemousse.
Pamplemousse.
Yes. That's better.
Yes?
Yeah.
It's not. Here, try this.
I don't think we have any other juices. Oh. Here. Making fun of stuff? Isn't making fun of stuff like, if you were to make Ian a drink right now, what would it be? It would be a daiquiri.
No,
it
would be that gin Ricky.
Yeah, probably be the gin Ricky.
Gin Stone Ricky.
Stone Ricky. Stoned Ricky.
No.
I'm not a big fan of Pepto and Jaeger.
There's pineapple juice over there.
I have it right here.
Pineapple juice.
She just came on the screen over here. That was when you had. Oh, that was when you drank the soda.
That's pretty much what we're doing, getting her to try everything.
Does that taste better? I'm just trying to figure out when that last, when I brought that down here.
Probably pretty flat.
Yeah, maybe a week ago. Really?
I like flat soda.
It does taste pretty nice.
Then why did you just pretend
because
to gag me?
Because it's a week old.
Because
it's a week old.
Yeah, but like liquid came out of your mouth.
Well, I don't want to get sick, but it tastes good. What's up with that Instagram sign?
Huh?
It's not swag.
Why isn't this swag?
Swag stuff we always get.
It's an Instagram sign from the sticker company that
sends
me my awesome drink stickers.
Sticker giant.
Yeah, I don't have any tonic water to feed her.
I fed her lime soda water. Or water.
You people want to feed me tonic water? It just doesn't sound humanly right. Where's the peach one? I like the peaches.
Okay, this is the peach one. Here you go.
You're scaring me.
Really? That's perfect. You can watch yourself after. Put that in your mouth. What? It tastes like a little orange, right?
Where's the peaches?
What's your favorite bitters?
Me?
I'm guessing that's the daddy.
Well, I say peaches.
Chocolate.
Peaches.
Mom.
Peaches. Yes.
My favorite bitter depends on the day of the week. I kind of like the prickly pear.
Ew, that's nasty.
You know what?
Prickly pear.
And there's your base.
Oh, I forgot I had this on. Glasses off. Oh, it smells so good. Do you want to know what my favorite drink is? That soda from the soda machine at Moe's with the peaches. The peach one. The peach Sprite.
Peach that's Sprite.
Amazing.
Probably the same thing as that. Oh, you know what I like? I like hella aromatic.
Ooh, I love this.
I like Bergen Hawk.
Bergen Hawk is what I get here. This is aromatic, though.
Yeah, those are good. Crafted aromatic is good, too.
Yep. Ooh, they have like a cinnamon flavor.
Ever try the rose grenadine?
Rose's grenadine?
No, rose grenadine. I think the rose's rose. The grenadine you used last week, I think, is what he's talking about.
Oh, they have a rose grenadine. Yeah, you can't see me? No, I haven't had a royal rose
that
grenadine.
Worked. Uh-huh.
You opened it last week.
If that's what you mean. Rose grenadine?
No, what you used last week. Simple
rose
syrup.
Rose simple syrup?
Yeah.
That's not grenadine.
No, it's not.
They said rose grenadine.
Okay, well, whatever.
It's Shirley with an S. She's made Shirley Temples on her YouTube channel. Which isn't that a lot.
But she needs to do again, but Daddy needs to do the screen.
Yeah, you need to work on that.
He needs to get the green
We're going to have a green screen, and I'm going to be doing mocktails. I'm going to be doing, like, a Shirley Temple in outer space.
why do you need to take off your glasses?
I don't know. I don't like my glasses on camera, because then it reflects, and then I look, like, weird.
What reflects?
The glasses, you can
Look at
see.
Mine. You see me in that picture, and my glasses aren't reflecting.
Well, whatever.
What do I have to do?
She what? Wants fire water. No, I don't! Tried that, and I died. I came back from the heavens. Like an angel.
Oh, the grenadine you used for the shot.
Oh, this. Have you ever had this?
What?
So have you
That's
this?
Not a very attractive bottle.
What do you mean? It's perfect for a bottle.
No.
I thought I muted this.
Jack Rudy!
Uh-huh.
Ugh. Oh, that doesn't smell pleasant at all.
Just put it in your mouth.
Try it.
It's pleasant. It's grenadine.
Well, that's not pleasant at all.
It tastes like cranberries.
Cranberry? How about pomegranate?
It's pomegranate, but...
No, I get cranberries.
Because of the tart.
I guess a little bit of pomegranate.
It's a little tart.
It's
dry.
Your taste buds are messed up,
tart.
What did I say?
Oh, it didn't go...
Like this? Like this?
Yeah, sort of.
Wait, no, it bumped on my teeth. Hold on.
Oh, that's good. Yeah, there you go. There, she just put the grenadine.
I'm like a little test dummy. Wait, I'll do it.
Wiggle.
But it's original.
What are you gonna do with that big fat butt?
And
wiggle,
organic.
Wiggle.
It's not spicy, is it?
But it's hot now.
Well, yeah.
Well, there's a lot of spices. They don't necessarily mean they're spicy hot.
Alright, I don't know if I'm going to have to spit this out, so. It smells really bad.
It doesn't smell bad.
Yeah, it does. It smells like really bad.
It doesn't smell like really bad. It's only gonna make one dot. It's got a dasher on top of it. Really?
Okay. Swag.
Yes, swag. Did you listen to voicemail?
Ew!
What's your favorite gin or tonic?
These are pretty bitter.
That tastes terrible! That was like.
You're still recording. Can you shut that off?
Oh, this one?
Yeah.
Or both of them.
That was swag!
You like Oxley, don't you? Favorite gin for tonic.
Oxley? Favorite gin for tonic. Yeah. Oxley. Or ethereal.
Boo!
Swag! Oxley. If you want to spend $65 on a gin.
Oh, I forgot this was on here.
You said that already. So you want some more of those?
No!
These are pretty bitter.
Yeah. I wonder why they call them bitters, Dad.
Cardamom, gentian root, star anise. That's like black licorice.
Mace, ew!
An orris root. I love me a good orris root.
I want a good orris root. Yeah, that sounds yummy.
It's like what a pig roots up under the ground, maybe.
Is Liam with Michael, Mom?
Yeah. She's that,
Question, basil, handle.
Man, she
basil,
looks like she has grown up a lot since her mocktails. I have.
What's the question? Basil Hayden, Sutton, Buffalo...
Versus Whistle Pig slash Buffalo Trace.
Oh, I don't know. I like them all. Oh, I see the question now. Is that a question?
Why am I saying ow?
It's
not even affecting me in any way.
I've never sat them side by side. They're all different. Really? Gross.
Oh, wait. You have, like, a really weird shaped head for this?
Well, that's because that's not a thing.
Let's just wait till it shows up so you can see yourself.
Feast does have alcohol in it, though.
No, it didn't. It was glycerin.
It has glycerin, but we found the alcohol. They have to publish how much actual alcohol is in it. I put them on our website. It's only like 4%, 6%.
Oh, here it comes.
Instead of 40 and 46%. Brandy and cognac are the same thing to me. I would probably say brandy because then I can go with cognac or brandy or armiac.
Don't raise your eyebrows. You're ruining it.
Not ruining anything. I'm just making...
On my screen, that's still on your
phone. Oh, it's a hair. Oh, that's pleasant.
Well, I'm pretty pleasant.
All right.
Look at it. It's logo after logo after logo.
Really? That much drama?
I think I popped.
Derrick, did you guys
ever get the gases out of me?
Finishing all the tippy cow. I still haven't got to the chocolate or mint. The orange. Just about until he took it away.
When you say it's gone.
Uh-uh, it's right there on the floor. There's just a little bit left.
Huh.
You wanted to
finishing the tipping out?
Did.
No, no, I haven't finished them or continued them. My goal wasn't really to finish them, though. Really? Oh, now you're perfectly fine.
It still burns. I look at that. Oh.
Alright, we done?
I am.
I gotta go clean up all that mess.
Before you go get lambs.
Yeah, before I go get lambs!
The lambs.
Alright. We're done here, folks. Have a good week. Until next week. Ow. It's all sticky. I used it for stirring. Ah! Good night, everybody. We'll see you next week. Do 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 do.
Think like I now have to change my undies from that startle.
Yes, we have a storm. There we are. What are you doing?
You look so demented.
Alright, here we go. Is it done over there? Have we waved our hands?
I don't know. I was way far behind, so.
Night folk!